country clubs, 50-meter yachts, upscale French restaurants. You're probably wondering why I'm listing off several high-end establishments. Well, today we're going to be focusing on something that's not only used to save lives, but is also aesthetically appealing enough to be used in these luxury locations. You probably would not have guessed it, but today we'll be robotically polishing stainless steel fire extinguishers. Unlike the standard painted red versions that we've grown accustomed to, these stainless steel versions take it up a notch. Not only do their highly polished surfaces look more sophisticated, they also have some practical advantages. One noteworthy difference is their corrosion resistance, making them a great candidate for outdoor use. These fire extinguisher bodies are crafted from a pre-polished material that are then welded together. Our goal was to provide a robotic alternative to an existing multi-step and multi-station process that would solve inconsistent polishing variations. Our process on this part is broken into two main categories, cut and color. For the cut process, we ganged up two of Norton's fixed abrasive buffs, or fab wheels. For maximum buff wheel life and to minimize compound usage, it's important to use the lowest speed that achieves your finish. A good starting point to target is 4,500 surface feet per minute. Since the raw materials were pre-finished, the cut process was mainly to remove color from the welds. We tested two compounds with the fab wheel. We started with the 4MAX Extra Fast Cut Stainless Steel Compound and then progressed to the 4MAX White Lightning Stainless Rouge Buffing Compound. It provided cooling as the abrasives in the fab wheel removed the weld color. This left the least amount of nominal scratches to be worked out in the color operation. The more aggressive stainless steel compound would have been a great option if the incoming material wasn't pre-finished. During the color process, it was necessary to swap over to a buff wheel without any embedded abrasives, which requires much more compound to achieve a high shine. We ganged up two cotton buffs and applied the 4MAX White Lightning Stainless Rouge Buffing Compound. Again, it's optimal to use the lowest speed that achieves your finish for maximum buff wheel life while minimizing your compound usage. A good starting point is to target 5,500 surface feet per minute. An alternative to the bar compound used, and what we recommended to our customer in their production, is to use a liquid compound to assist in furthering automation capabilities. Since a lathe can rotate the workpiece, it was the perfect option for this polishing process as we didn't have to blend between passes. Our customer's current process utilizes an industrial lathe to rotate the extinguisher at a constant speed. We wanted to mimic this process as closely as we could, so we decided on the Powermatic 2014 lathe. With its variable speed and low end torque, we were able to rotate the part and apply enough force with the buff wheels without stalling the lathe. We chose to rotate the part in the opposite direction of the abrasive. This allowed to achieve a much higher surface feet per minute without having to increase the speed of our servo spindle. It also made it much easier to blend the finishing passes. This is mainly due to the fact that we could traverse linearly across the part instead of having to articulate around the part and maintain a constant feed rate. The PushCorp AFD92 is our largest passive compliance device, which allows you to apply up to 250 pounds of force. This is ideal since we're not changing orientation on the part. The compliance stroke allows the monitoring of your buff wheel wear in case you need to swap out to a fresh buff wheel. The PushCorp STC0612-BT40 features a powerful 12 horsepower servo motor. This spindle provides high torque at the lower RPM used for the buff wheel. The tool changer allows the user to switch between cut and color operations automatically. Like drafting in a car to increase fuel efficiency, we made sure to optimize the heat for our desired results. Doing a quick tool change while the tool is still hot means you can use the residual heat of the cut operation during the color operation to achieve a bright finish. Let's put this all together and check out the application video. The cut process utilized the abrasive grains embedded in the Norton fab wheels to remove the color from the welds. The 4MAX Rouge buffing compound mostly provided cooling for this operation. A tool change to a cotton buff was performed and we followed up with a color operation. The 4MAX Rouge Buffing Compound helped polish the part to a high shine. Hey, welcome back. If you want to see your parts in the demo lab or have an interest in our equipment, please send an email to sales@pushcorp.com. Check out our robotic stainless sink graining and polishing video if you enjoyed this application process. We'll link that in the description below. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you next time.